reception, baptism, confirmation, to preach the word, celebrate sacraments, is quite extraordinary. For 17 years, I was the Bishop of Rhode Island, not Long Island, Rhode Island. I think you could take a ferry there, about the size of half Long Island. But I'm delighted to be here today. Well, the gospel begins with on the third day. And if you can imagine another time in scripture when we hear the term on the third day, it is pointing to the resurrection of Jesus. So there's something about this gospel that speaks about new life and hope and a change of the world order. For on the third day, Jesus conquered death. And while this is not a death gospel, it is a gospel of new life and hope. And one of the reasons is because nobody knew how the water became wine. The wine stewards, the professionals in the business of wine, had no idea how it happened. And yet it says in parentheses, which you'll see when you take your leaflet and booklet home with you today, in parentheses, as though it's an afterthought, the stewards didn't know, but the servants knew. And so this reveals to us the new way and the new life, that the servants should know what the steward didn't know, what the professional didn't know. Those who served the wine were given the insight by Christ to present to the people this glorious first miracle. I think in our time, we see servants as being the last to know. In fact, when I do my laundry in the laundry room, many times, the people there are maids in the building. And they think that I'm a maid, too. Because I suppose most people don't do their own laundry, and their own cooking, and their own cleaning. So I go down there, and they think that I'm one of the servants. And I like that. Because there is a knowledge that servants have, which is deep, and oftentimes hidden, and oftentimes secret. Just like secretaries, entrusted with the secrets. Very important roles that people don't always honor. So I like being down there, and they talk to me about how I fold my sheets, and how they fold their sheets, and there's some kind of camaraderie that I don't think would happen unless they thought that I was one of them. And Jesus lifted up the servant and revealed to all of us the power of knowledge and goodness that they have. Now, this was a wedding in Cana. And Cana was considered to be a rather sleepy village of the time. Not that Wantagh is a sleepy village. But, I mean, Jesus didn't do this in Jerusalem or in one of the bigger towns. Didn't go to Nazareth to do this, or to Bethlehem to do this. He went to Cana, which shows again that third day, that new life. The fact that oftentimes things begin in the most unusual of places and with the most unusual of people. This is Jesus' new way of bringing to life God's message. And the other thing that was interesting was that at the wedding feast, oftentimes those of a certain family were over here, those of the other family is here, the other group is here. It's stratified, and the best wine went to the important group. Now, this happened in one of my family weddings. They have a table for the cousins over here, a table for the second cousins, the table for the children. And my mother felt as though she was at the wrong table. Not good. She wanted to be with this set of cousins, not with that set of first cousins. Imagine what it's like to set up seating arrangements for a wedding, or for whatever. It is difficult, and there are always people who are upset. In Jesus' time, all the best wine went to the better tables, to the better class, to the better people. But at this particular wedding, it didn't happen that way. At all the other weddings, the worst wine, was given first, so that people would be drunk, and they wouldn't drink as much as of the good wine. And save some money, you know? But at this wine, at this wedding, the tables were turned, and the best wine was saved to the end. Everybody got the best wine. It wasn't by your class, your race, your distinctive characteristics, everybody got the best wine. So, Jesus is showing to us a true and greater life, a new way of thinking and doing. Everyone receives the gift. Now, we have today a whole group of people who are going to receive the gift. And the gift of Christ is life. It is life and hope and grace and peace and eternal life. It is a third day event. It is receiving the resurrection in a new and more comprehensive way. Because all of you who are being confirmed, baptized, and received are adults, I think you witness to the rest of us of what it means to rethink your faith, of what it means to look deeply within and ask the hard questions of life. What do you believe, and how will you live out those beliefs? You're all mature people who today make a commitment that may place you at odds with your upbringing, with your families. You may be different from them because you have taken on a new name. You have taken on a new identity. Today, you follow Christ in a new way, a different way. You are one with him out of your choice. And for all of you who will witness these vows, have you rethought your faith? Have you questioned once again what you believe, who you follow, and what will it look like in your daily life? These folks are witnesses to you of what can happen when you reassess the faith that you proclaim. One weekend, I went up to New Hampshire, and I was just ahead of a snowstorm. And once I got there, the snowstorm absolutely kept us in for 3 days. It was a ferocious, one of those northeasterners that just went up the coast, and we were buried in it. And so my friend said, good, we have time for a puzzle. Well, I've never liked puzzles. And all I can think of is 3 days with a puzzle with 1,000 pieces. I could think of nothing worse. There was lots of food in the house, so that was okay. But we started the puzzle. And I found out that I was getting obsessed by this puzzle. And it was annoying me to no end that I was wasting so much time trying to put all the gray pieces together, and the blue pieces, and the red pieces. My friends were teaching me how to do a 1,000-piece puzzle. And so there it was, at the end of this time, almost all the pieces were in place. And it was actually getting exciting. We were almost finished. And when we were finished, three pieces were missing. And I was so disappointed. But it didn't change the picture that the puzzle showed us. It didn't change the picture. We all knew what the puzzle was. But there were these three empty pieces, places. And I thought to myself, isn't that what life is about? The puzzle of life, you're putting all the pieces together, and then you find out at least three are missing. There are many missing pieces. You still have a sense of the life you have lived. But the missing pieces are there nonetheless, and the chances are you're never going to find them. As hard as you look, those pieces will always be there. But this is the season of Epiphany. And could it be that just where the missing pieces are most prevalent is where the light of Christ has room to enter? Could it be that just what you thought was lost is found for Jesus? Could it be the emptiness, the water jug, of all those gallons of water? Could it be just the place where you become wine? Rich, beautiful wine for everyone to drink. Not just one group or another group, but everyone gets to drink the wine that you give them out of your emptiness. Isn't that an extraordinary thought? That Jesus works in our emptiness to make us full. And not for ourselves alone, but for all the guests. For all the household of faith. So, those to be baptized, confirmed, received today, come to you not as complete puzzles. It's bad enough to be a puzzle. But then to be an incomplete puzzle might be disappointing. But that's how God made us, incomplete, so that his love, his grace, his beauty can be revealed through us. So his life becomes our life. And if we have light, the whole house shines, and we all see with a new set of eyes, a new heart, and a new mind. The servants knew this. They knew this. They knew life could be changed by Jesus. And we who serve learn the same thing. Thank you to all of you who will give yourself anew to Christ today and reveal to us that through the missing pieces, all the love.